In this video, I'm going to cover the introduction to solid modeling and generative drafting using SolidEdge. Solid modeling is a technique of complete, valid and unambiguous geometric representation of a physical object. It contains vertices, edges, exterior surfaces, interior surfaces, etc. as you can see in three examples here. It may be useful for engineering simulation and analysis. The applications also include CAD/CAM, FEA, stereolithography and many more. There are many ways in which you can represent solids in 3D modeling. One of them is wireframe model. You can see there are only wires or vertices and lines or curves. Another way is to represent the solid as it is in the form of shaded object like this. Sketch-based modeling is one of the widely used, most popular technique to create 3D models for the use in 3D computer graphics applications. A sketch is a two-dimensional environment where we can draw sketches. You can draw sketches on different planes. There are three default planes available: top, front and right planes, as you can see. Sketch in SolidEdge contains default origin and default planes, as you can see. And also there are some sketching tools to construct the two-dimensional profile known as sketch. After the use of sketch, protrusion, revolved protrusion and lofted protrusion are the three major features of solid part module used in creating simple objects such as prisms and pyramids. As you can see, protrusion creates material by extruding the sketch in a normal direction. Revolved protrusion creates material by rotating a sketch about a given axis. And lofted protrusion command creates material by connecting two or more sketches which are drawn on parallel planes. Now we will see the three useful features of solid part module. First one is sketcher. You have protrusion command here. There is revolved protrusion command. There is lofted protrusion command. And there is option for creating parallel planes. There is something known as edge bar, where all the features that you create will be stored in a tree structure in a sequence. You can see the edge bar on the left side. If that is missing from your screen, you can always switch on from Tools Edge Bar. There are some options for changing the visibility, like wireframe, making solid view with visible edges, etc. There is option for changing the different views, top, front, side, isometric view, etc. These are the options for panning, zooming, fitting the object to the screen, rotating, etc. A pentagonal prism 30mm side of base and 60mm axis length rests on HP on its base with one rectangular face perpendicular to VP. A cone of base diameter 30mm and height 50mm is placed on top of this prism. In SolidEdge, click on solid part module. Now you can see there are three default planes, namely front plane, top plane and right plane. Click on sketch. Select the top plane. Draw the sketch of a pentagon. You can draw this anywhere on the screen. It's convenient to use length and angle method for drawing this pentagon, as it is drawn on the screen now. A sketch should be a closed profile always. You will see square boxes at the corners if lines are properly connected to each other. If not connected, connect them using connect relationship, as it is done in the screen now. Show the dimensions on one of the edge. Draw medians to locate the center of the pentagon and make those lines construction. Observe that in the current position, Pentagon has one of the edge parallel to VP, but we want one of the rectangular face of the pentagonal prism to be perpendicular to VP, hence rotate and move the pentagon appropriately as it is done in the screen now. Return from the sketcher, click on protrusion, choose select from sketch option, select the sketch, tick yes mark, then enter the height of the prism and click on finish. You can see in the front view, one of the rectangular face is now perpendicular to VP. If you want to modify the sketch, you can right click on the sketch in the edge bar to the left and click on edit profile. When you return, your model will be updated automatically. To create sketch for cone, click on sketch icon and choose the front plane. Draw the triangle. Triangle should be drawn at the center of the top face of the prism. Give appropriate dimensional constraints like height and radius of the base of the cone. Once the sketch is completed, return from the sketch. Now use revolve protrusion command, select the sketch, tick yes. Choose the axis of revolution and enter the angle 360 degree to complete the solid. If any dimension given is incorrect, you can edit the sketch always and get the updated 3D model. Now save the solid part file. Note that cone can be created using lofted protrusion command also. To create a drawing, you can go to file menu. Click on new and choose normal.tft and click OK. Right click on sheet and go to sheet setup and set the sheet size to A4, then fit the screen. Click on drawing view wizard, choose the solid part file you have just saved, click open. Click on next, choose front, go to custom. Check the front view, reorient if needed, close the window. Choose front, right, top and isometric views, click on finish and click on the drawing anywhere to place the views. Select all the views and set appropriate scale. Drag the views to place them appropriately. Show the given dimensions in the orthographic views, create the axis. Save the drawing file. For your understanding, you can check the actual dimension and isometric length on the isometric view. Select the isometric view and make it a shaded view with visible edges and click on Update Views. You can use text command to write your name, problem number, etc. on the sheet. If you want to modify the solid part now, you can go to Window menu and go to the solid part window. Do the modifications here and then go to the drawing window again and update the views. You can save the solid part also as an image file. Hemisphere of 20 mm diameter is placed centrally on the frustum of a hexagonal pyramid such that the flat face of the hemisphere is on the top face of the frustum. Frustum of the hexagonal pyramid has 25 mm sides of base and 15 mm side at the top and the axis length 40 mm long. Go to solid part module, select the sketcher and top plane for drawing the sketch. Construct the hexagon. Draw the diagonals to locate the center of the hexagon and make them construction. Now use move command to locate the hexagon exactly at the center. Now exit from sketcher. Create a parallel plane at a distance of 40 mm. Select the new plane and go to sketcher and draw another hexagon on that plane of appropriate size. Now use lofted protrusion command. Select the bottom sketch, select the top sketch. While selecting top sketch, you identify the joining points, that's very important. Then click on preview. Part is constructed. Now go to sketch on front plane and draw a sketch of 1/4 of a circle exactly at the top face of the bottom solid. Now use revolve protrusion command. Select the sketch first, tick yes, then select the axis for revolution and enter 360 degree and complete the solid. If you want to change the dimension of any profile, you can right click on that sketch and go for edit profile, change the dimension. Once you exit the sketcher, the solid will be automatically updated. You can save the solid part. Then go to file menu and say create drawing. Click OK for the template. Click on next. Select front and go to custom. Check the front view and close the window. Select front, side, top and isometric views. Click on finish. Place the views on the sheet. Do the sheet setup. Drag the views to fit it to the sheet. Set the appropriate scale. Show the dimensions. You can save the drawing file. You can make the isometric view shaded. You can also save this as an image.